This is Broadway and Hollywood leading man Robert Lansing and his wife, his leading lady, Gari Hardy. This is intensely emotional and sentimental Heywood Hale Broun and his wife, Jane. This is President Nixon's favorite guest, Orson Bean, and his wife, Nixon's most beautiful guest, Carolyn. And this is the one and only Bill Cullen and his wife, Anne. These four celebrity couples are here to play He Said, She Said. And here he is. Here's your host, Garagiola.
Great. That was the greatest entrance since Emperor Tiberius Caesar walked into the great mixed baths of Caracalla holding a live chicken in each hand.
It was a wonderful reception for a 240 hitter.
All right.
Well, you guys want to play,
awful,
right?
Joe.
Okay. Not you, though, Bill.
No,
Bill Cullen.
I'm glad your tailor has a sense of humor, Joe.
Jade's a fat jack. All right. Bob, you're the only nice guy here. I can see that.
I'm just not awake yet.
All right. Now, you've all had your chance the next half hour. We're going to see if your wives can recognize you by the stories you tell us about your married life.
Oh, mercy.
Wives are backstage, can only hear us when we want them to, like this. Ladies, would you please press your buttons? Good. All right. How you doing back there?
Fine.
Great.
Now, when you do that, we see you on the screen, and from now on, any time you want to talk, please press that button. Now, each of you is playing for a different married couple in our studio audience, and the winner will get a week's stay at a Holiday Inn. Ladies, I'm going to cut you off right now. I'll talk to you a little bit later.
Nice.
Bye-bye.
Good.
Okay. Opponents?
My wife has the nicest button.
All right. We're going to find out. I'm going to give you a topic. Let's start over. I'm going to give you a topic. I want you to come up with an association so personal when your wife hears it, she knows it was you.
Right.
Okay, clues, one or two words. Right. First topic I have for you is how she keeps the spark alive.
What spark?
Why don't you say that?
Huh?
Why don't you say
I'll
that?
I'll take a chance and say that, but there's no story that goes with it except my fire's been out for years.
What spark?
What spark,
all
yeah.
All right. Okay, we've got your response, Bill Cullen. Let's see who was next here. Orson Bean.
I would say dinner wine. We are great admirers of Bacchus.
Yes, he's
the god of wine and revelry.
Jim Bacchus.
Our life is one...
Jim Bacchus?
Our life is one constant search for a decent, cheap table wine. We consume enormous quantities of the grape.
Okay. Table wine. And that's how she keeps the spark alive.
How she keeps the spark alive. And me, her, she don't need it.
All right, we've
with
got
a
it.
Button like that.
Dinner wine. How she keeps the spark alive, Woody?
Well, I would say counter-irritant. I'm not as nearly as humming as Orson is. I mean, he paints a picture here which makes us want to stop the show.
He did.
counter-irritant to me simply means that my wife is of the belief that perhaps one of my most powerful emotions is anger, and if she can annoy me, everything else will follow.
So counter-irritant is yours. Okay.
I've often heard Jane say, Woody, you're beautiful in your wrath.
We've got the three responses. Let's go backstage. Hello there, backstage.
Hi.
Hello.
Remember now, press your button as soon as you recognize your husband. We said, how you keep the spark alive. And he said, meaning, you know, how you keep the spark alive. And he said, what spark? What spark?
Nobody's going to press the button.
Time is up. Ann Cullen.
Well, what sort of answer is that? No spark.
No, not no spark. What spark? I didn't understand a question, dear.
Welcome to divorce court.
Right.
And
sorry.
I'll have to take 10 points.
What did he say, Joe?
He said, what spark? He said,
That's right.
You tell her, Bill.
Well, he asked me if there was a story. I said, there's no story except my fire's been out for 15 years. That's all.
That's not true.
Thank you, dear. Is that why you keep the... Never mind.
I'll take the 10 points from you, Ann. We said how you keep the... how she keeps the spark alive, and he said, dinner wine. Oh, we've got a couple of ladies with the dinner wine. Let's see who was first. Carolyn Bean.
Very sweet of you to say ladies with the dinner wine instead of winos.
Hi, Piggy, a little more, a little, have a little more, you live a little better.
Right.
We recently switched over from Italian Swiss colony to Roma.
So we can afford to drink more of it.
You want to add to that story, Carol?
What more is there to say?
About the time the chicken fell in the vat of wine. You know the story.
That's pretty much what he told us. We're going to give you the 25 points, Carolyn. Just never know when to stop with you two.
Can't applaud anything.
How she keeps the spark alive, and he said, counter-irritant. Counter-irritant. Jane Brune.
I don't know why, I just have a feeling that that would be something Woody would say. Was it?
Why do you think he said it?
Well, I don't know. He likes to use big words like that, and then I have to say, what do you mean? And then he gets to explain it.
Would you just kind of give her a hint? We're going to bend the rule a little bit, Woody.
Well, I think the reason I said it was that...
You didn't understand the question.
You are of the belief that I come alive when angry, and therefore, let's see if we can't make him sore.
Oh, you're explaining why I annoy you sometimes?
That's what he was explaining, Jane. We're going to give you the... We're going to give you the 25 points, because it was Woody who said that. Okay, more of Who Said, She Said, right now, this message.
Have a Holiday Inn in Staten Island?
Sure, they got them all over.
I want to stay in the one in Staten Island.
Well, we're going to buy you a vat of wine and send you out there. That's what we're going to do. Hey, I got a new topic for you.
Okay.
The new one. Okay. Something you won. Something you won. W-O-N.
Won.
Something you won. W-O-N. Something you won.
That's a good topic.
Time is up, guys. Go to the next topic. Oh, we got four losers here. All right. Something she really dressed up for. Something she really dressed up for. Bob.
Well, for my opening here, which was also my closing.
Save the dress.
I did this marvelous play, which was called Bright Tower. And it was Gary's first Broadway opening night. And so she really put it on. She put on the dog.
What can be our clue?
Opening night?
Opening night. All right, we've got your
response. We're going to get four answers for that.
Let's see who was next. Orson Bean. Something she really dressed up for.
I would say dungaree party.
Dungaree party?
She made... Well, there was a party that we were invited to. A socialite friend of ours, Christina Palazzi Bellin.
Ooh.
A beautiful Italian countess who posed nude for a well-known magazine. invited...
Really?
Yeah, she did. Yeah, Vogue or something.
I got a copy of it right
here. Happy? Yeah, I'd like to see that.
Okay.
That's a very dog-eared copy. I got a better one here. I carry it around. She invited us to one of those crazy socialite parties. The ladies were supposed to be in evening gowns and the men in dungarees. She made an evening gown out of dungaree material, cut 3 inches above the navel. This is from the floor. It elicited such cries from the attendant males as, makes you proud to be an American. And, you'll never drown. Things like that.
What's your clue then? Dungaree party?
Yeah.
Okay.
Other cries I could give you.
Like?
I'm going to kill my wife.
All right. Let's see who was next here. Woody Broom.
Well, my clue is almost anything. And my explanation is that if somebody says, come on down to the White Tower. We have an extra hamburger. My wife will say, the suit, do you think? The purple? I don't know. I don't have shoes to go, but I say the hamburger is getting cold. Can't we just go down with whatever? Oh, no, I couldn't go out like this. So what almost, you dressed up for is almost anything.
Okay, let's go backstage and see what happens. Hello, ladies. Y'all set to play?
All set.
All right, press your button now and you recognize your husband. We said something she really dressed up for. And he said almost anything. Gary Hardy.
I take any advantage I can to dress up. And I'm very proud of all my clothes. And I usually have a new outfit that I make for every time that we go out. And it has to be that.
Well, Gary, it wasn't Bob who said that. And
right.
I'll have to take 10 points
that?
From you.
It's true, but, you know.
I'll take 10 points from you, and I'll ask Jane Brune where she was. We thought you would recognize that.
Oh, where was I? What was the question again?
Where you were.
I was wondering what you were doing out there and why there was so much laughter.
Well, we said something she really dressed up for, and Woody said almost anything. We thought you'd recognize that.
Almost any part, Woody.
Well, what she means is being an actress, she dresses up for almost anything she does, but it was my argument that you can't go down to get the paper without getting a matching ensemble with it.
Well, I'm so glad you think so. You don't remember me in the jeans and the old shirt all the time?
The shirt is a pale blue to go with the dark blue.
I'll have to take 10 points from you, Jane. We said something she really dressed up for, and he said opening night. Opening night. Carolyn Bean.
Figured nobody else buzzed. Maybe it was me. Well, I've dressed up for a few of Orson's opening nights.
We're rich. You can afford 10 points.
It wasn't Orson that he just told you. I'll take the 10 points from you. Gary Hardy, I'll have to ask you.
No, yes.
Well, I'll have to take 10 points because you didn't recognize that.
Yes, it's the long story, right?
We said something she really dressed up for, and he said dungaree party. Carolyn Bean.
15 points.
Had to win a few points back. Yeah, we went to a dungaree party, and boy, did I dress up. What more do you want to know?
Describe the outfit in your own fashion.
I'm sure you did it, honey.
He did, Carolyn, and we're going to give you the 25
points. It elicited such cries as you're a credit to your race.
Okay, ladies, we've reached the halfway point in our game. It's time now for you to change places with your husband, so would you come out on stage, please?
Promotional consideration furnished by National Airlines with new nonstop service Miami to London. National says you're going to have a great flight. Now let's meet the wives. And here they are. Here is Ann Cullen, and the Cullens have 90 points. Next is Carolyn Bean. Beans have 140 points. Here's Jane Brown. Brune, the Brunes have 115 points. And Gary Hardy, the Lansings have 80 points, Joe.
Okay, John, we're going to see how good the husbands are recognizing their wives in just a moment, but right now, this message. On stage we have with us Ann Cullen, and the Cullens have 90 points. This is Carolyn Bean. The Beans have 140 points. Here is Jane Brune. The Brunes have 115 points. This is Gary Hardy, and the Lansings have 80 points. So there they are. Now your husbands are backstage. Remember, each of you are playing for a different married couple from our studio audience in the winner's prize of week's stay at a Holiday Inn. Topic I have for you now is something that keeps him from being perfect. Something that keeps him from being perfect. Carolyn Bean.
He'll kill me, his temper.
Temper? Really?
Mm-hmm.
How bad is it? Come on.
Well, I mean, he's very sweet to me. He does it very privately, but you hear it all over the house. And, I just had to have a carpenter come in and patch up the hole in the wall.
Does he throw things or does he swing?
Oh, no, he threw a book at the wall just because he couldn't find something and picked it on whammo.
Listen, if he
so every time that our kids, are acting terrible, and he says, I don't understand where they get their temper. It must be from you.
Blames you, huh? All right, we've got it, his temper. He's got a good arm. I started to say, if he can hit, I can get him a job in the outfield. Okay, something that keeps him from being perfect, Ann Cullen.
His waistline.
Oh,
I got to get even.
That's it was waistline.
Well, he was a very thin man when I married him, but he's put on 20 pounds.
It's a tribute to your cooking.
And he was perfect when I married him.
Oh, I see.
Right? But now he's got this bloop here, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll buzz.
He'll buzz.
I
will
give him a very bad time about it.
Okay, his waistline. Something that keeps him from being perfect, Gari.
It has to be his cards. He does magic with cards and coins. And it's fine, except he enjoys doing it at dinner when we're out. And I have no one to talk to and nothing to do, and I get to sit there and watch all of his tricks. And so it has to be his cards, that's all.
You sound like you're real choked up about those tricks.
Oh, yeah. They're great. They're very good. And I enjoy them.
Okay, his cards. Jane, you can't really play because we only take three out of the four, but I'm kind of curious, what one thing keeps Woody from being perfect? What would you have said?
I would have said, I guess, not very kind, his lack of head hair.
His lack of head hair? We're going to go backstage now. His lack of head hair, huh? He's got a lot of hair compared to some people I know.
I like lots.
Oh, I do too, and so does Woody. All right. Okay, we're going to go backstage and see what happens now. Hello, guys. Y'all set back there?
Yeah.
All right, now, press your button as soon as you recognize your wife.
I'd know her anywhere.
All right. We set. Something that keeps him, meaning you, something that keeps him from being perfect. And she said, his waistline. Man, we had the bells of St. Mary out here. They were all ringing. Let's see who was first. Well, Bill Cullen, you were first.
I think he deserves it.
I do, too. I think what she's doing is getting even with me for the wet spark crack. Actually, Joe, as you know, I'm a physical culture nut. And I constantly exercise. That's a lie. I don't do anything. And I eat too much, and my waistline is now the same as my chest size. And I'm working on my hips at the moment. But I think that was Ann who...
That's what she told us, Bill. We're
Thanks,
trying to
lady.
Give you the 25 points.
I knew it.
Reset. Something that keeps him from being perfect, and she said his temper. Oh, we got two of them on our screen. Who was first? Orson Bean.
Yeah, I'm sure it's me. I must admit, I have the foulest temper since Attila the Hun. Our son, Max, has a foul temper, too, and every time he mouths some vile epithet which he's picked up on the streets, my wife says, well, there goes your son. It's in his genes.
That's what she told us, Orson. We're going to give you 25 points. Very good. Wow. Reset. Something that keeps him from being perfect, and she said, his cards. Bob Lansing.
Well, so far, any of the others would have fit me. But I stopped smoking about a year ago, and I do card magic. And it's become sort of a nervous habit, and which drives my wife a little batty, I think.
Tell him when you do it.
I'm not going
to tell him when you do it.
Wouldn't tell him when I do it at all. I'd tremble in my seat to tell him when I do it. What did you have in mind?
Dinner.
Oh, dinner, right. Oh, yeah, at the table and at the, you know, and friends. And then friends think that I'm terribly bored with them because I sit there and, you know, flip cards.
Why?
And things.
Why would they think that? We're going to give you the 25 points, Bob. Very good. I'm going to take two responses. There's two of you. The topic is massage. Massage. Gari.
He always bothers me about giving him massages, and I always promise tomorrow, because today I've got too many things to do. And so it's got to be until tomorrow.
Until tomorrow. Sound like a hit song. Okay, until tomorrow. Massage, Carolyn Bean.
I'll say loves foot.
Loves
he
foot.
He particularly loves to have his feet massaged. And he has me and the three kids all trained to rub his feet.
Three kids and you, that's four.
Yeah, right. And we, you know, take turns rubbing his feet and line up at the bottom of the bed while He stretches out and sighs.
That's got to be something.
Yeah.
Love's foot. We'll go backstage and see what happens. Hello, guys, you set?
Yep.
Yeah. Uh-huh. All right, now, remember to press your button now and you recognize your wife. We said massage. And when we said massage, she said, until tomorrow. Until tomorrow. Orson Bean.
Well, I figured no one else is going to ring and I could afford the 10 points, and it might be me. I could be massaged until tomorrow if you started a week ago Thursday.
Well, it wasn't Carolyn who said that. I'll have to take 10 points from you, Orson. Bob Lansing, we thought you would recognize that.
That's like, you know, the temper. I figured four people could push on that. I could be massaged until tomorrow, and Gary, I suppose.
But I keep telling you until tomorrow. You ask me, and I say tomorrow.
Oh, put it off until tomorrow.
Yes.
That's right. Yeah, she cracks my knuckles instead, you know.
We'll have to take 10 points from you, Bob. We said massage, and she said love's foot.
Oh.
We've got a couple of guys on our screen. Who was first? Bill Cullen.
Oh.
Joe, I love my wife's feet.
No.
She has the most, she has the prettiest foot in the world. One's not so hot, but the other one is beautiful. No, I realize that was not me. I'm just trying to make up for the other one.
Well,
I'm sorry, dear.
It wasn't Anne. I'll have to take 10 points from you, Orson. I'll take 10 points from you because you didn't recognize it. You knew it was Carolyn. You were just late.
You mean I lose 10 points each time?
That's right, Orson. That's the way it goes. Sorry, Orson, you ninny. Well, time to get our final scores, meet our big winners, but first this message. Our couples are all together. Johnny, who's the winning couple?
Joe with 145 points. The winners are the Beans.
Great. Okay, Orson, in front of you, you have a card. Would you read the name on the card, please?
You can't see?
Yeah.
Mr. and Mrs. Alex Moran from Windsor, Ontario, Canada.
Ooh. Wow, great.
Way up in the corner. There they are.
And there they are, way up in the back. And you want an exciting week for two of the glamorous holiday inn of your choice in the U.S. or anywhere in the world, such as Gari, Indiana. Get the Holiday Inn habit and go!
And I just have time to say goodbye. Bye.